Hello there, welcome back to the Yoga, the old Git reacts, reviews and sometimes reminisces. Welcome back to the Yoga's lair, my grubby little dark hole, deep below ground. Still hoping to move up to a cavern at some point, but only time will tell. So, some of you that have been here from the beginning may be wondering when you actually can do a reaction video and not react, review or reminisce. Well, today's the day when I'll finally do a reaction to something I've not heard yet. So, Spectral Law. Their album's just come out recently. I saw this YouTube video come up and left it be. Tempting though it was. It's been left to languish until such time as I could get my arse into gear to review it or react to it even. So I've got the album and I have to start at track two every time so I don't listen to this. You'll probably glean that I'm not a stranger to Spectral Law, glorious band that they are. And so don't expect a jaw-dropping reaction to this because I'm aware of what they do, but you never know. They might pull something out of the hat here that does make my jaw scrape the ground. Enough waffle. Let me find the bit on it. Do you know, my professionalism just goes up in leaps and bounds. Jeez. Let's go. Sorry, I'm gonna have to stop it. My jaw hasn't hit the floor, but it ain't far off. Fucking hell, what a way to start an album. Or any song, really. Excellent stuff. You never quite know what you're gonna get with Spectral Law, because although he has his sound, the frame with which that sound bounces can be quite high or broad. But that is one way to start an album, giving it the licks, the bollocks, bam, whoa. Yeah, Spectral Law, black metal, but not as we know it. The thing I love most about Spectral Law is you can have this raw, rampaging cacophony, and interwoven into it is the lead work that he puts in there, the intricacies of his guitar, which makes it extraordinary, really. Some of you who are old enough and have an interest in custom motorcycles might remember there was a time in the 80s when custom motorcycles were being brought out, big capacity engines, but the custom builders were using a fellow called Don Bloxage to engrave the engine casings in this intricate engraving and etching, often depicting hunting scenes or what have you. Really, really excellently crafted stuff. And it reminds me, this is a musical version. This is the heavy duty music with those filigreed and etched and engraved elements to it, which lifts it way above the pack. You know, the Spectral Law tracks I've been listening to years, and I still find elements that I'd not really noticed before. This looks like it's going to be no different. Let's go. One of his things, when the tempo decreases on most instruments, he'll up the tempo of the drums. Extraordinary. Just a maelstrom of music, wasn't it? This is a lyric video. I don't think you need lyrics for a song like this. The music tells the story, and even though music doesn't give you the fine detail of what it's always about, this paints a picture. You know, there are chapters to this song. You know, you form your own story. The video gives it that sort of mystic space type aspect, but you know, if you close your eyes and listen to it, you can make any story you want up, with the climaxes and the lows that any story has, and that's what Spectral Lore do. If you ever go to a museum where a picture or a painting takes up an entire wall, that's sort of a Spectral Lore for you. They fill all available space with drama and spectacle. You cannot get bored of a Spectral Lore track, song, anthem, whatever. Well, that was an event. It's what I wanted from a Spectral Lore track, and it gave it in buckets. So much drama within there, you know, the even when the tempo drops, the impact doesn't. It's a full song. You know, you can imagine if it was one of those submarine films where they drop to certain depths, the water starts to buckle, the hull. That is a Spectral Lore song in adverse. It's bursting outwards rather than bursting in. And he never ceases to amaze the fellow that is Spectral Lore. Always worth checking out if you know Spectral Lore but don't know Mithras. His other project, one of many, I suppose, Mithras, is equally delightful. And again, I'd emphasise the fact that that is quite raw music, but the emphasis around the lead guitar work makes it something magnificent, something you can never tire. I never tire of, and I know many others don't either. So the work and commitment that has to go into a song like that, and the album, when you listen to the album in general, you can only marvel at his creativity. So no, my jaw didn't touch the floor, but it was the whiskers on my chin certainly were touching it. Video painted a picture, but as I say, you don't need video or lyrics for a Spectral Lore song to tell you a story or paint you a picture. Excellent stuff. What I hoped for and what I got. Anyway, so there you go. That's my first reaction video, as opposed to reviewing or reminiscing. I'm sure you've got your own ideas of what I ought to look at. Let me know. Do the clicky bollocks if you want. And I'll see you next time. Something that routs out your earwax, or maybe not. Cheerio from the ogre.